some of the financial statements. Now let's look at the elements of accounting. We are slowly getting into the meat of the subject. In order for anyone to be able to generate the financial statements or have a complete grip of the accounting subject, there are certain basic things that one should be aware of. And as such, it is imperative for us to know about the elements of accounting. Because once we are clear with these basic terms, it would be easier to cover the accounting process. There are three elements that we need to understand. They are assets, liabilities, and capital. Let us start with assets. We will understand what an asset is, and I'll give you some of the examples, and we will discuss about the different types of assets. So what is an asset? Assets are the items that your company owns that can provide future economic benefit. And at the opposite side of assets, we have liabilities. Assets put money in your pocket. Liabilities take money out of your pocket. Let's look at the examples of assets. We have cash. We have cash equivalents. We have accounts receivables. We have inventory. We have power, plant, and equipment. So these all things will fall under the category of assets. Let's talk about them one by one. Cash. Cash is the most important asset of an organization. It is important for an organization to have cash because it shows the liquidity position of a firm. How much cash does the firm hold in hand? Because if you have cash, it means that the firm is in a good position to pay out to its vendors, to its employees, and carry on with its operational activities without much issues. So cash is considered as the most important asset for an organization. And we have something called cash equivalents. Cash equivalents are called assets because they are short-term investments. These investments can be into treasury bills, government bonds, securities, etc. These are called assets because they can be readily converted into cash whenever there is a need for cash. It is cash, but in other form. Okay. Now we have accounts receivables. In short, it is referred to as AR. And also sometimes it is also known as trade receivables. Accounts receivable is nothing but the amount of money that we are to receive from the customers in future. Since we receive the money from our customers or our clients, it is considered a form of cash. Because cash is an asset, accounts receivable is also an asset. Now you might ask, what if the customers or the clients do not pay us back? For that very reason, we have something called purchase order. Let's say you have company A and company B, and company A is selling items to company B. In that case, company B would issue something called purchase order to company A. Now, this purchase order is a legally binding document. In the event, if company B doesn't pay company A its money in its due course, then company A has all the rights to sue company B. So that is the reason a purchase order is taken from companies for any exchange of services. And that is how they would recover the money. Okay, so accounts receivable is an asset because we're going to get money from other company at some point in time. Okay, now we have also something called inventory. What constitutes as an inventory? It is the raw materials, goods that are semi-finished or fully finished. And why are they considered asset? Because we can sell them and we can generate cash. Hence, it is considered as an asset. Just that we're discussing about inventory, let me also briefly touch upon what is a raw material, semi-finished goods, and fully finished goods, so that we are clear with these terms as well. Raw materials is the basic components that a company uses to make its products. And semi-finished is partially finished goods, whereas fully finished is a fully ready product that can be sold into the market. And then we have something called power, plant, and equipment. It is denoted as PP&E. So PP&E, this is how it is referred to as. And most of the organizations will have the properties like buildings, factories, land, and etc. And then machinery and the equipment. Okay. These all things hold economic and monetary value. Because if we sell them in the market, we get cash. Hence, they are considered as assets. The difference is that these are tangible assets, which we can see, feel, and touch. And these assets are vital to the operations of the business, because if we do not have machinery or the plant or the equipment, then there is no way that a company can go ahead and produce goods to sell in the market. And these are all hefty investments, okay? Because these are all hefty investments, these hold economic and monetary value. If there is a need, you can very well sell them and generate cash. Hence, they are considered as assets, okay? But there is one thing that you need to remember. Some of these assets will depreciate over a period of time, like the machinery, the building, the equipment. These all things will depreciate over a period of time. I think the exception is the land, which will appreciate over a period of time. So we need to consider the depreciation value as well. Okay, I will talk about them when we talk about depreciation. So think of asset as anything that you can make cash if you sell them, in the event you need capital for the business. Now that we've seen the examples of assets, let's also categorize these assets. And if I expand the asset types, you will see here they're divided into two primary categories: current assets and fixed assets. The other name for current assets is short-term assets. And the other name for fixed assets is long-term assets. Let's first see what is current assets. Current assets are those assets that can be easily liquidated. When I say liquidated, it means it can be converted into cash if needed. For example, let's say you have gold. It can be liquidated in a day if needed. Likewise, you have shares of a well-known company. They can be sold at a click of a button and can be converted into cash, right? So any asset that can be liquidated easily is termed as current assets. And from the examples, the short-term assets are the cash equivalents, the accounts receivables, and the inventory, okay? Because they can be sold and can be converted into cash within a year's time. In the accounting world, if we say short-term is within 1 year or within the accounting period. And the long-term means something that goes beyond a year, two or more. Now, one important point to make a note of is any expenses that you make upfront, like prepaid rents, prepaid expenses, are considered as assets. Can you tell why these expenses or the rents are considered as assets when they should be considered as liabilities? The reason is because if we have not paid them upfront, they would have been counted as a cash in hand. And for that very reason, anything which is prepaid, even the expense or the rents or anything, is considered as a current asset, because you also don't have to pay them going forward because you already have made the payment. Now let us see what fixed assets are. This is simple to know. The other name for fixed assets is long-term assets. Fixed assets are those assets that can be used in the business operations that have a span of more than a year. And examples of fixed assets are property, plant, and equipment, often abbreviated as PP&E. And apart from the current assets and fixed assets, we have two more asset categories, like tangible assets and intangible assets. What is the meaning of tangible? Tangible is nothing but something that you can see, feel, touch, and sense. So from the above example, if we carefully observe, can cash be felt and touched? Yes, right? Because it can be touched and felt, it is a tangible asset. Similarly, can you touch the inventory? Yes, it can be felt and touched. And this is also called as tangible asset. Now let's look at the intangible assets. This is interesting. There is a certain criteria for an asset to be considered as intangible. Okay. The first criteria is it cannot be a current asset. The second criteria is it cannot be a physical asset. And the third important criteria is it should have future economic value. When I say future economic value, it means something that can generate money. So if we take the example of, let's say, cash, can it be an intangible asset? So let's look at the criteria and understand whether it is an intangible asset or not. So the first criteria is it cannot be current asset. Is cash a current asset? Yes, very much. So it is not an intangible asset. And also, cash is something that you can see and feel. since it is both current asset and physical asset, it cannot be considered as an intangible asset. Let's say accounts receivable. Can we consider this as an intangible asset? Let's look at the criteria again. Intangible asset says it cannot be a current asset, whereas accounts receivable is a current asset. So it cannot be considered as an intangible asset. So if we look at the examples of intangible assets, we have brand value, we have goodwill, we have trademarks, we have patents, we have intellectual properties, we have copyrights, and we have logos. Brand value, why is it called as an intangible asset? To understand, can you feel and touch the brand value? Does it have a physical presence? The answer is no, you cannot feel and you cannot touch it. So you may get the question, why is even brand value considered as an asset? It's just a name. It's just the brand name. How can it be an asset? To give you an example, when I Googled the brand value of Coca-Cola name, as per 2020 valuation, it is valued at $84 billion. Meaning, if Coca-Cola is ready to sell just its name, nothing else, not the property, not the company, but just the name. There are investors, there are people who are ready to purchase the name at $84 billion. Because these investors know if they can produce some cola drink and stick its name there, it will sell because of the brand value. Hence, brand value is an important asset. Though it may not exist in physical form, though it is not a current asset, but it is a very important asset. Intangible assets are very important. A side note for you, if you really think about the brand is nothing but a perception in people's mind that was built over a period of time. You cannot see it, but it plays an important role. So piece of advice from me, build your brand as an individual. Your actions, your commitment, your ability to stick to your commitments, and ability to show results will create a perception in people's mind. And this can happen only if you're consistent over a period of years. And this is how you build your brand. All right, let's go back to the topic. So let's see what are the other intangible assets. So brand is one. Likewise, goodwill, trademarks, patents, intellectual properties, copyrights, and logos. These all are examples of intangible assets. So that brings us to the end of assets category. So we have discussed about current assets, fixed assets, tangible assets, and intangible assets. Now let's move on to liabilities.